So, hello. Today we are going to see one problem from Hacker Earth, and its name is the feasible relation. So I'm just studying the statement for now, and after that I will explain in a simple way what the question is saying. Let's just see the statement once. What is it saying? So, as a programmer, you sometimes have to deal with some math, and this is the time to do it. You are given a list of binary relations, equalities and inequalities. So the thing is that we will be given some binary relations. Whether the variables are equal or not equal, suppose A equal to B is given and A not equal to D is given, this type of relation will be given to us, and our work is to output yes if we can assign integers to input variable in such a way that you can satisfy all equalities and inequalities. Means the relations that are given that should be satisfied. Suppose 1 equal to 2 is given and another relation is 1 is not equal to 2. This is not possible because two numbers can be either equal or not equal. It can't be both. So we have to check whether all the relations are feasible or not. Okay, the input format, what the input format is going to be. Let's see the input format. T will be denoting the number of test cases, and N and K is given for each test case. N will be the number of variables and K will be the number of binary relations that will be given to us, and for K lines we will be given the relation in the form of x1 or x2, whether x1 is equal to x2 or x1 not equal to x2. This type of relation will be given to us for the number of relations that we have, and what the output format is going to be. It will be going to be the number of test cases T lines, which is T. We have to output yes or no whether that test case is feasible, that relation in that test case is feasible or not. So this is the problem. Let's see it in the one note how we are going to solve this problem, and then we will come to the code part, coding part. So let's come to the one note here. So this is our one note. Now what the question is saying, what we are going to do for C. This is the sample test case that we are given to us, right? This is the sample test case that we are given in the question to 1 equal to 2, 1 and 2. So we are going to make the graph first and then we will check whether this is feasible or not. With the equal to signs, all the equal to sign relations that we have, we will see it as an edge. Okay, equality represents suppose an edge, and one equal to two means one is one vertices and two is the other vertices. So one equal to two is there. So for the first test case, I have made this here. This is the first test case for this input one. So since two is the number of test case here, this is the two is the number of test case, and this is the number of variables, this is the number of what relations going to be. So these are the two relations that we have in this test case, and we have to check whether it is feasible or not. So 1 equal to 2 is there. Whenever there will be equal to sign, we will make as an edge. So 1 equal to 2, there is an edge between 1 and 2, and 1 is not equal to 2. So we will first leave the not equal to statements and store it somewhere, and we will check after that whether that not equal to part is feasible or not. First we will create the graph using the equal to signs input, and not equal to relations will be stored somewhere. That will be the vector of pair of int comma int. That is one, it is the pair, it is going to be the pair of integer and integer, and it is going to be the vector, okay? And its name, suppose we are giving the not equal, this is the name. So 1 equal to 2 is there, so connect, we have created the graph 1 equal to 2. Now we will check 1 not equal to 2 whether it is feasible or not. For that we will create the connected component using the DFS. We have already we know that how we can generate the connected component numbers. So this is one connected component, so we can give, this is another test case, so leave it, focus here only. So 1 equal to 2 is there, we will call a DFS function from main, and these all are the same connected components, so both have will be the value 1. This can be done using the DFS. So this is the connected component vector. Now if the connected component 1 not equal to 2 statement will come, then if the 1 and 2 have the same connected component, then it is not feasible, because if it is in the same connected component means they are equal. And 1 not equal to 2 in 1 and 2 have the same connected component, so it is not feasible, so our output will be no. Okay, the second test case that we have is 1 equal to 2 and 2 not equal to 3. Okay, so let's focus here first using the equal to relations. This is the test case explanation, so focus here only. This part, focus this part now. So 1 equal to 2, so we will create an edge between 1 and 2, and the second state we can create the connected component using the DFS. So 1 and 2 are in the same connected component, so we will give the same value as 1. Now after completing all the equal to sign relations, we will come to the not equal to sign part. So the not equal to sign part is 2 not equal to 3. So we will check the connected component value of 2 and 3. Since the connected component value of 2 and 3 are not equal, that means this relation is feasible, because they are not in the same connected component. So our output should be yes. Okay. This is the test case that we have in the question. One more test case that I have taken. See the test case here. Number of test cases going to, this is the input. Number of test cases going to be 2, and number of variables going to be 5, and number of relations going to be 5. Okay. So first one is 1 equal to 2. So we have created an edge between 1 and 2. This is the edge here. 1 equal to 3. This is the edge here. 4 not equal to 2. So this one we will store in the vector of pair of int and int. Okay. Not equal vector of pair of int and int. This is the vector that we will use for storing the not equal to part values. For storing the not equal to part values, we will use this vector. So suppose we have stored in the not equal to part in that vector, okay. We will go to the next equal to sign, 5 equal to 4. So 5 and 4, we have created one edge here, 3 not equal to 5. We will again store in that vector of pair. Now we will start read after completing all the equal values. Our graph has been created, and now we have to check whether the not equal to relations are feasible or not. So what we are going to do, we will first create the connected component vector using the same method, DFS method. So this is the connected component vector that we are going to get. 1, 2 and 3 are this from the same connected component, and 4 and 5 are from the same connected component. So we have given the values 1 and 2. Okay, we have created the connected component. Check the not equal relation part. The first one is 4 not equal to 2. 4 not equal to 2, right? So connected component value of 4 and 2. This is 2 and this is 4. They are not equal. That means they are feasible. They are not in the same connected component, and that's all we want for the output of yes. Okay, so these are feasible. And 3 not equal to 5, we will check. So connected component of 3 here and 5 here. Okay, so 3 and 5 we will check. The connected component value are not same, means they are in this different connected component, means this relation is also feasible. Since all the not equal to relations are feasible in this test case, so our output is going to be yes. Okay, next test case is that 5 and 4, these are the four relations that we have, and total number of vectors are 5. Okay, you can see using the equal to sign, first we will create the graph, and then we will create the connected component vector up, and then we will check the not equal to relations whether they are feasible or not. Okay, so first let's create the graph using the equal to relations that we have. 1 equal to 2, we have created one edge between 1 and 2 using the adjacency list. Okay, 2 not equal to 2, 3, store this in the vector of pair of int that we will create. Then 5 equal to 4, we will create one edge between 5 and 4. 1 equal to 3, we have created one edge between 1 and 3. So using the equal to relation, we have created the graph. Now we will create the connected component vector, that which vertices are in the which connected component numbers. So we will call a DFS function from 1, and it will traverse all the edges related to 1. So we have given the numbers 1, and then we will call the 5. If they are not visited, then connected component value of 5 and 4 is 2, as you can see. Now we will check the not equal to part, whether they are feasible or not. Here 2 not equal to 3 is there. Now see 2, and here is the 3. The connected component value of both the numbers are equal. This means what? This means they are equal, but this relation is saying that they are not equal. Means this relation is not feasible, so our output will be no. So this is the method we are going to follow for solving this problem. Let's see the problem coding part now, how we are going to do that. So come here. Here is the ADJ vector adjacency list that we are going to create. Here is the visited vector that we are going to use for DFS function. Here is the number of variable, number of relation, and the current component, as we have to find the connected component vector also. So we are taking one current component variable so that we can increment in the next call of the DFS from the main function. Okay, this is the not equal to vector of pair of int that we have, and this is the connected component vector, and this is the DFS function. See the DFS function, this is the simple DFS function only. If from the main function a DFS value will be called, we will visit that value. This is the only thing that we have added in the DFS. Current connected component of V equal to current connected component, and we will increment the current component each time we call from the main function. We will now in this part we traversed all the child of the V connected to the V or the, all the childs of the B. So this is the DFS function only. This is simple. Now we come to the main function. This is T for test cases. We have taken the input of number of variable, number of relation. We have resized the value of visited array, adjacent list, connected component using this resize function in STL. And now we have to take the inputs of the binary relations that so A is for first integer, B is for second, and REL from whether the relation is equal to or not equal to. It is of type string. And we are taking answer initialized with true, means this is the feasible relation initialized. We are going to follow it for number of relations that we have. So if it is equal to, what we are doing, if it was equal to relation, then we are just creating the graph, means adding in the adjacent list. But if it was not equal to, then we are pushing it into the not equal vector of pair in pair vector of pair, we are pushing that values so that we can use later for checking that whether that relation is feasible or not. So if the relation is equal to, then just put it in the push it in the adjacent list. If it is not equal, means else, then just push it in the not equal pair of vector of pair. Okay, you are understanding, I hope. Means the now the graph is created. Okay, after the graph is created, what we were doing, we were finding the connected component vector for recognizing which vertices are in which connected component. So for that, what we have to do, we have to get the for number of variables, we have to iterate. This is the for loop that we are going to iterate over. Okay, if that variable is not visited, then we will increment the current connected component and we will call it DFS from them that vertices. Okay, if that vertices is not visited, then we will call it DFS and we will increment the current component so that each time the DFS call is called from the main, the current component is incremented and all the vertices connected to that a vertice will get the that value. Now we have created the current component vector. Now after that, we have what we have to do, we have to check whether the not equal to relations are feasible or not. And where we have stored that not equal to relations, we have stored in the vector of pair in the whose name was going to be not equal, right? So we are iterating that not equal vector of pair using the not equal dot size k equal to 0, and the a value is going, how we are going to access the a value, that we are going to access using the dot first, not equal k dot first, not equal k dot second. Now if what we are doing, if the connected component of a and b are equal, means the connected component of a suppose a not to equal to b is there, and the connected component of both the a and b are equal, then it means what? It is contradicting our relations, that first one is saying that it is not equal and other is saying that equal. This means their contradiction is there, so we have to output false. So we have make the answer false and we will break from this loop, because at least one contradicting relations will print the we have to print the answer false, at least one. So now we will check if this will check all the not equal relations from the vector of pair. After that, after completing that loop, we will check if answer equal to true, then we will print yes. If answer is not equal to true, that means false, we will print out no. As simple as that. And after that, we for another test case, we have to prepare and we have to initialize everything with zero. So visited vector also initialized with zero. Adjacency list are also cleared. Current component vector is also initialized with zero. Not equal vector is also cleared. And we have to initialize again the current component, current connected component with zero. So this is how we can do that. And I have already submitted this part. You can see it is accepted. So this is how you can solve this problem. Hope you have learned some new things from here. Thank you very much. Like, share and subscribe.